Another terminology that is essential for a researcher is the assumptions. Assumptions are nothing but they are the factual statements which are true for that particular research. The findings of the research are viewed in the light of these assumptions. Many a times the assumptions and hypotheses, they are confused with one another. We will see how both the terminologies are different. When we compare the two terms in terms of the definition, the hypotheses are defined as, in order to focus our information gathering, we try to identify possible solutions or explanation that is correct. These educational guesses about possible differences or relationships or causes are called as hypotheses. Whereas the assumptions are defined as, they are the statements if what the researcher believes to be facts but cannot clarify. The importance of the hypothesis is the development of the theory. They also play major role in bringing the focus to the research. The role that the assumptions play is the providing the ground on which the whole building of the research is built. If the assumptions are removed, the whole research will not find its place. How do the two differ in terms of the base from which they emerge? The hypothesis emerge from the earlier studies as well as from the objectives of the study at hand, whereas the assumptions emerge from the insight of the research. Whether the researcher has the choice of using either the hypothesis or the assumptions, if the researcher is conducting a quantitative study, then the researcher does not have any choice. The researcher has to write the hypothesis for every quantitative study. In case of qualitative studies, writing the hypothesis would be optional. It would depend on the choice of the researcher whether to write the hypothesis or otherwise. In case of assumptions, it is definitely completely a choice of the researcher whether the assumptions are to be written, and if yes, then how many assumptions are required for that particular research. Where are they placed? The hypotheses are placed immediately after the objectives, and this sequence is very logical because we have seen that the hypotheses take birth from the objectives. So it becomes easier for the researcher as well as for the reader to check the exact linkage between the objective and the hypothesis. And the assumptions are placed after the hypothesis. We will see the example of how construction-wise two terminologies differ. The sentence of hypothesis would be something like, there is significant difference between varsity athletes in high school who smoke and those who do not smoke in terms of athletic accomplishments. So as we have seen in hypothesis, the word significant difference or significant relationship, that one of these have to appear in the sentence of the hypothesis. Whereas the sentence for the assumption could be as simple as, younger children have language difficulties in expression. So it is not a technical formal kind of a statement, but it could be a general statement that even a non-researcher can use in the daily life. So thus we have seen that the two terminologies are very much different from each other. They have their own significant role to perform in a research. We shall now see some of the mistakes that are made while writing the assumptions. A researcher, especially the novice researcher, she writes a long list of statements in the name of the assumptions. Now, assumption, only that one sentence or the one or two facts to be picked up which have direct bearing on the research and not the whole list of the statements as assumptions. At times, the statement of assumptions has a very far-fetched relationship with the problem at hand. It doesn't have really any impact on the problem at study, but has a very sparing relationship or almost no relationship kind of a situation, and still such statements are written as assumptions. At times, a varying situation is written as assumption. For example, the students may be liking the prayers in the school. Now, in this case, there are possibilities that some students may like the prayers and some of them may not like. So, there is no fixed fact, and we cannot even take a judgment on how many of them may be liking and how many of them may not be liking. So, this a statement like this cannot be written as an assumption. Thus, in this session, we have seen how writing assumptions is important, and especially how assumptions and hypotheses are different from each other. In this complete session, we have got familiar with some of the very important terminologies that the researcher comes across as soon as the research topic is decided. The clarity on each of this terminology brings in more clarity and more focus in the research that is undertaken. Hence, the researchers must spend enough time to understand these terminologies, and even further in defining the terminologies in the context of her own research.